are now listening to a Purple Crayon Productions broadcast.
And this is Wannabe, written and directed by Sophia Varnai, featuring Tara Schomer, Mia Moko, Sophia Sandoval Ferris, Connor Breen, Matt Piper, and Sophie Falvey.
We go walking in the distance, looking for a stranger, looking for attention, fighting passion, burning in the soul.
Another beautiful evening, home alone. I kicked off my shoes and sunk into the couch, opened a can of Pringles, reached into my pocket and felt the flash drive in my hand. I closed my eyes and for some reason my heart was racing. I thought maybe I'd check my phone. No texts. That made things easy. No emails. Okay, that was fine. Maybe I'd try to watch some TV.
I will always love you, Thea. No matter if...
The afternoon of carnage ended with one of the suspects, later identified as one.
Los Angeles and Orange County expecting to see 1 to 3 inches of rain on Saturday and then about 1/4 inch to 1/2 inch of rain on Monday.
Okay, hopefully there was something on YouTube. Maybe I'd pull up Ella's page. No harm. I was just looking into another case.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm gonna be showing you what I eat. What's up you guys? I hope you've been enjoying the warm weather like I have. They were so sweet to send me some of their swim logs. So I'm gonna take you along for a day. Remember, don't forget to like and subscribe. One of my favorite, I'm obsessed with. Say hi, baby. I
love. And suddenly, it was 1 a.m. and there were no more videos left. I reached my hand into my pocket to make sure the flash drive was still there. I brushed my teeth and fell asleep with it safe in my palm. And then it was the next day.
Good morning, everyone. I appreciate you all taking time out of your day to go over our new user interface. So I'll make this brief.
There you are. I saved you a seat.
Thanks.
You oversleep?
What? Oh, yeah. Yes.
Well, I get it. All the change, finding your place, it's exhausting. But you'll settle in. At least I did. Well, kind of.
Thanks.
Now! It is important to remember that we place the highest burden of trust in our employees. You are America's eyes and ears, the smoke detectors that sniff out the fires before anyone gets burnt. If there's a problem, you come to us right away. You set off the alarm so that no one gets...
But I was only half listening. The other half of me was thinking about what was in my pocket. As soon as I was back at my desk...
What case are you on?
What?
What case are you on?
Oh, Ella Dennings? Nothing too fishy, just some minor flags, but I just thought better safe than sorry, so just checking things out.
Cool. But what's the flash drive for?
I just wanted to save a user instruction guide I found last night onto this computer while I'm still figuring out the new system.
Oh, gotcha. Well, let me know if you ever need help.
Will do.
I guess I'll leave you to it.
I stared at the little folder on my desktop. I opened up Google Chrome and decided to check my email. A couple of messages from Old Navy about weekend sales, one from Verizon, and nothing else. I closed Google Chrome. I opened the folder, and suddenly I had a map with Ella's location. A little red dot only 8 miles away, her desktop screen, facial recognition data, security camera footage, and a very busy day ahead of me.
3 weeks later.
Excuse me, Sam?
Yes?
Would you mind stepping into my office? I just wanted to check on you and see how you've been adjusting to your new position, since it's almost been a month.
I'm adjusting well. Thank you.
Really?
Yeah, I feel like I'm finally getting the hang of life here.
Well, that's good to hear. Unfortunately, your work is telling a different story. Your productivity analytics are surprisingly low. You've been late filing reports, sorted only a fraction of the daily average of cases, and not to mention that you've been on your phone during company meetings.
Well, I'm new.
What's going on, Sam?
Nothing.
You were promoted for a reason. Whatever is happening, it needs to stop. You have an important job, and I truly believe that, so you need to start doing it. Don't make this harder than it has to be, okay?
Okay, sorry.
Good. You can go back to your desk.
That morning, Ella had a green smoothie for breakfast. I drank day-old coffee. She walked her toy poodle Daisy around the neighborhood. I stared at a wall. She scripted a couple videos. She had avocado toast with smoked salmon for lunch and watched TV. I ate an egg salad sandwich and watched her. She watered her plants. I got scolded by my boss. She was on her way to Yogi Studio Southwest, and I...
Where are you going? It's the middle of the day.
I need to blow off some steam. I'm going to yoga.
Everyone, as the last few people filter in, go ahead and find a comfortable place in the room to lay out your mats. Please also have your yoga blocks by your side, as we'll be starting with those.
Excuse me? Hi.
Hello, is everything okay?
Yes, yeah, I just don't have a mat. Sorry, I left mine in my car.
Oh, don't worry, you're welcome to go get it now.
Yeah, I just parked kind of far away. Do you have any here that I could use? I'm so sorry.
Of course. 1 minute.
I also, I left my blocks too. Are there any extras?
It actually looks like people are already using all of our spare ones. Maybe there's someone you could share with? Here's your mat.
I took it and started dragging the strip of foam to the back of the room. And then I saw her. Ella. Her eyes were sparkling in the sunlight beaming in through the window, and she was smiling. She started walking and tucked a wisp of hair behind her ear, and then...
Sam? Is that you? It's me, Ella.
Oh, wow. Yeah, hi. Yes, I'm Sam from high school.
High school.
And you obviously already knew that. Hi. Wow, this is so crazy.
What are the odds?
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know you did yoga.
Yeah, I come here all the time, actually.
Well, I heard you saying you needed to borrow some blocks. I can share with you if you want.
That would be amazing. Yes, thank you.
Cool. I'm in the second row if you want to join.
Yeah, let me just get my stuff.
So I went to the back of the room, grabbed my hunk of rolled up foam, dragged it past all the girls in matching pastel workout outfits, and unrolled it in the second row. Next to her.
So, how have you been?
Oh, you know,
just... Hello, everyone. Let us begin today's class. Thank you all so much for sharing this space with me. I'd like to begin by grounding ourselves in our bodies, in this room with these people. So find a comfortable seated position and just begin with a deep inhale. And exhale. Take another inhale.
She smelled like springtime.
And exhale. Now we're going to move into child's pose.
I guess I'll see you around.
Yeah. I'm having this Halloween party on Friday if you want to stop by.
I would love to.
Okay. Here's my number. Maybe I'll see you then.
Ella smiled, and suddenly everything felt possible. I found a Lululemon and bought my first set of workout clothes. I went to Whole Foods and picked out spinach and ginger to make the green smoothie she was always drinking.
It wasn't great, but it's the thought that counts. Every night after work, I watched movies with Ella. Well, I watched Ella watch movies, and I pretended she could hear my commentary. Imagined her grabbing my hand when we got to the scary parts. And then in the blink of an eye, it was Friday.